गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू क्लास 12 बायोलॉजी यूनिट फर्स्ट चैप्टर सेकेंड सेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन इन फ्लावरिंग प्लांट्स। टुडेज टॉपिक इज टाइप्स ऑफ माइक्रोस्पोरोजेनेसिस। On the basis of cytokinesis after karyokinesis, karyokinesis is nuclear division and cytokinesis cytoplasmic division. On the basis of cytokinesis after karyokinesis, the process of microsporogenesis may be three types. First type is successive type, successive type. In this type of microsporogenesis, nuclear division and division of cytoplasm take place simultaneously. It means after meiosis first, two nuclei are formed. It is followed by ball formation. Second ball formation take place after meiosis second. It is found in most of monocotyledonous plants. Means in meiosis cell division, one nuclei divided into four nuclei. After first meiotic division, one nuclei divided into two. Then ball formation take place. Then two nuclei divided into four, and again ball formation take place. In this way, four nuclei are formed. Simultaneous type, in this type the two nuclear division of meiosis first and meiosis second take place simultaneously, and after the formation of four nuclei, ball formation take place around them. Means first karyokinesis is completed, one nuclei divided into two, two into four, then ball formation starts to form four cells. The microscope, the forms are arranged in tetrahedral forms. It is found in most of the dicotyledonous plants. There are some other types of cytoplasmic division. In some plant, first and second division in microspore mother cell are transverse type, so that four microspores are formed, which are arranged in a linear tetrad, means one above other. This type in Oleanthus tuberosa, microspore tetrad is linear or T-shaped. In Carnus and Magnolia, decussate type of tetrads are found. Arrangement of microspores. The four microspores developing from a microspore mother cells may be arranged in following types, like iso bilateral. Four microspores lie side by side, tetrahedral. Microspores are arranged tetrahedrally. and fourth is backside. Decussate in this type, upper and lower pair of microspores are arranged in opposite directions. T-shaped in this type, the upper two microspores are horizontal in position while lower two are vertically arranged. And fifth type is liner. Fourth, megaspores are arranged on a vertical axis in a single line. Compound microspore. Normally, pollen grain become free from each other, but in some plants like Calotropis, Dramaceae Strophii, Pelodia, pollen grains combinedly form a group. These group of pollen grains are called compound pollen grains or compound microspore. In Calotropis, all the pollen grains of a microsporangium together form a mass of pollen grain, which is called pollinium. Two pollinium joined together by means of corpusculum. Each pollinium contain a large number of pollen grains. You know the structure of a mature pollen grain. Structure of mature pollen grain. Each pollen grain is a multicellular uninucleated body having two lateral valves. Ball of pollen grain comprised of two main layers, the outer exine, which is rough, and thinner at one or more places from where pollen tube emerge out. Outer exine and the inner intine. Exine is chiefly made up of sporopolletin, which is resistant to chemicals and biological decomposition. In cross-pollinated species, exine is covered by a alloy, viscous and sticky substance called pollen kit material. At one or more places, the exine is very thin. These regions are known as germ pore, through which the pollen tube grows out during pollen germination. Intine consists of peptocellulosic substance. This exine intine, at some places, it is thinner to form germ pore from where in time appear as a pollen tube. Dehiscence of anther. After maturation of pollen grains, anther ruptures at one or more places and pollen grains become free. At maturity, middle layer and septum are degenerated and so that only anther ball contain only epidermis and endothecium. Dehiscence of anther normally take place due to formation of longitudinal slit. In some plants, dehiscence take place due to the formation of terminal slit or formation of pores. On maturity, water come out of the cell of endothecium so that external thin wall of these cells constricted inwardly. it create a pressure on cells of stomium and it get splitted and pollen grains come out through the slit formed by splitting. मेल गैमेटोफाइट एंड इट्स डेवलपमेंट. मेल गैमेटोफाइट एंड इट्स डेवलपमेंट व्हाइल स्टिल इन द एंथरलोक पोलन ग्रेन बिगेन टू जर्मिनेट ड्यूरिंग द फाइनल कोर्स ऑफ डेवलपमेंट द न्यूक्लियस ऑफ मेच्योर पोलन ग्रेन्स मूव टूवर्ड पेरिफेरल पोर्शंस where it divide mitotically to form a large vegetative cell toward the center and a small generative cell toward lower portions or toward periphery. Before releasing from the anthers, nucleus of pollen grains divide into two nuclei at the center vegetative nucleus and toward periphery generative nuclei. In majority of flowering plants, pollen grains are usually released from the anther at the two-celled stage and reach the stigma of carpel. Further development of pollen grains take place in the stigma of carpel or stigma of female gametophyte. The germination of pollen grains on stigma due to presence of mucilaginous substance on the surface of stigma. Stigma contains a sticky substance, sometimes it is a sugary substance. Due to presence of mucilaginous substance on the surface of stigma, pollen grain swell and start to germinate on stigma. The entire come out in the form of a germ tube through germ pore. This inner layer of the pollen grains comes out in the form of pollen tube which move through style and reaches to ovary. It is known as pollen tube. Generally a single pollen tube is formed after germination of pollen grains. However, in the member of Malvaceae and Cucurbitaceae, more than one pollen tube are formed. As has been said earlier, pollen grain contain a vegetative or tube cell and a generative at the time of dehiscence of anther. Nuclei of both the cells come into pollen tube. Generative cell divide to form two male nuclei at maturity. Vegetative or tube nuclei disintegrates. Both these nuclei come to the pollen tubes and travel through styles. During the course of further development, vegetative nuclei utilize as nutrients or generative nuclei. Growth of pollen tube takes place within stigma and ultimately reaches to the micropyle of ovule. It is followed by fertilization or fusion of gametes. Before entering into the ovary, generative nuclei divide to give rise two male nuclei or two male gametes. during the process of fertilization, one male gamete fuses with the egg nuclei to form zygote and second male gamete fuses with secondary nuclei to form 3N endosperm nuclei. Female gametophyte. Structure of a carpel or pistil. Unit of female gametophyte is carpel or pistil. Female sac apparatus is represented in the form of gynecium or pistil, which is considered to be a female reproductive whorl of a flower and is composed of one or more carpels bearing female spores or megaspores. Gynecium consists of stigma, style, and ovary. Lobar swollen portions held on thalamus is ovary. Above ovary, a long slender structure is style, and at the top of styles, a knobbed or multifold structures form the stigma. Stigma, style, ovary. Ovary contain ovule or megaspore. The terminal small rounded head is called stigma, whereas slender star supporting the stigma is called style. Ovary is the chamber, swollen basal part of the pistil, and it contain one or more little roundish or oval shaped egg like bodies called ovules. A structure of ovule or megasporangium or megasporangium ovule is a multicellular oval structure which originate from the placenta and come to lie inside the chamber of ovary. A mature ovule is differentiated into two parts, stalk or funicles or funiculus and the body. This is funicle or funiculus and it is the main body of ovule. Funicle is a slender multicellular structure from which ovule is attached to placenta. Placenta attached with ball of ovary. The point of attachment of body of the ovule to its stalk is known as hilum. This point is called hilum. Main body of ovule is composed of thin wall, parenchymatous cells called as nucellas, the cells which are filled in the main body of ovule is called nucella. This is filled in whole body of the. It is usually surrounded by two cellular cores called the integuments, outer integument and inner integuments. The integuments are incomplete at the apex of ovule, forming a pore called micropyle. Through this opening, the pollen grains pass into the nucellus, pollen tail, which enter to the ovary, enters into nucellus through micropyle in most of the cases, and through micropyle enter to the embryo cell, where it releases two male gametes. Basal portion of ovule just below the junction of nucellus and integument is called chalaza. This portion is called chalaza or chalaza region. This is the micropylar region. Embedded inside the nucellus and toward the micropylar ends, there is a large oval sac consisting of few cells called the embryo sac. This is embryo sac. Mature embryo sac contain 8 cells. Out of these, 3 cells are micropylar end. This is micropyle and this is micropylar ends. These 3 cells form egg apparatus, out of which middle larger cell is egg cell, and 2 laterals are the synergids or accessory cells. These 3 cells form egg apparatus. 2 polar nuclei situated at the center of embryo sac are called secondary nuclei, and 3 cells toward the chalaza ends are known as antipodal cells. After fertilization, synergids and antipodal cells are utilized for nourishment of developing embryo. Egg apparatus consists of a large central egg cell and 2 lateral small synergids. After fusion, the 2 polar nuclei form a single diploid cells called secondary nucleus, means 4 cells formed at the micropylar end and 4 at the chalaza end. 1 nuclei from each end travel toward the centers, where they form diploid secondary nuclei. 2 haploid nuclei form a diploid structure. Development of megasporangium. Development of megasporangium or ovule. Now we have read the structure of mature ovule. How this ovule develop inside the ovary? This process is called development of megasporangium or development of ovule. Development of megasporangium or ovule start inside ovary as a protuberance on placental tissue. Placenta is a small outgrowth originated at the ball of ovary or inner ball of ovary. It grows gradually and forms a somewhat triangular structures known as nucellus. 2 layer of integuments arise from the base of nucellus and gradually cover the nucellus from all sides except the apical pore. That apical pore is later known as microphile. Types of ovules. Ovules are of many types on the basis of position of funnel and micropyles. These are orthotrophous type, when the ovule is erect, so that the funnel, chalaza, micropyle come to lie on same vertical planes. Here is attached funnels. Here two instruments which form all are in a vertical planes. Micropyle, this chalaza ends, funnel and embryo side. An orthotrophous type, second type is an orthotrophous when the body of ovule is completely bent and fused along the funnels. The fused portion is called rete, hilum and micropyle is close together and chalaza is situated at the other ends, as we have seen in earlier diagram. This time hilum and micropyle lie close together and chalaza is situated at the other end. Such an ovule is said to be an orthotrophous or inverted. For example, pea, bean, castor, etc. This is the most common type of ovule in angiospermic plants. Hemi-anorthotropous type ovule, when nucellus and integuments lies more or less at right angle to the funnels, means funnel is attached with the main body here. Thus, the micropyle and chalaza come in a transverse line. In place of vertical line, they go to transverse line. The ovule is called as hemiorthotrophous. Example, ranunculus, campylotrophus, when the body of ovule is curved and bent round like a horseshoe, so that micropyle and the chalaza come to lie at one fourth. The ovule is called as campylotrophous or curved. Member of family Leguminaceae. Amphitrophous or transverse. These are types are based on the position of funnel and micropyle and chalaza. Amphitrophous are transverse when the body of ovule is placed at right angle to the funnel. The ovule is called amphitrophous or transverse. Hilum, chalaza and micropyle all are separated from one another. Sixth type is sarcinotrophous. Here the funnel is exceptionally long and form a complete circle. Around the ovule, which is free from it except at a small area at the end of funnel. Opuntia and other member of family, Cactaceae and Plumbaginaceae, Femcle is too much long and it is attached near one end. Now the microsporogenesis. Megasporogenesis. During the initial stage of development of ovule, primary archaeosporial cells get demarred at the apex of nucellus below the epidermis. How nucellus is formed? This you have read already. Nucellus is formed by the cell of placenta. Placenta is an outgrowth formed at the ball of inner ball of ovary. Any of the cell of placenta remarked as archaeosporial cells. It divides pericleanally into an outer primary parietal cells and primary sporogenous cells. Archaeosporial cells give rise to two cells, primary parietal cell or primary ball cell and second primary sporogenous cells, as you have read in microsporogenesis or development of male gametophytes. Here also archaeosporial cells divide mitotically to give rise two cells, primary parietal cells or primary ball cell and primary sporogenous cells. In development of male gametophytes, primary sporogenous cells give rise to four cells and all four remain functional. But in development of female gametophytes, primary sporogenous cells divide to give rise four cells, out of which three degenerates and only one remains functional. This is main difference between male gametophyte and female gametophyte. Here the primary sporogenous cells enlarge in size and act as megaspore mother cell. Megaspore mother cells enlarge in size and divide meiotically to form a row of four megaspores. Of the four cells, upper three cells degenerate and appear as dark cap, while the lowest one functional and is called as functional megaspore mother cells. It gives rise four cells, out of which upper three cells are degenerated and only lower most cells remain functional, known as functional megaspore mother cells. The functional megaspore cells enlarge greatly and form the embryo sac. The growing megaspore enlarges upon and let absorb the other three non-functional or neighboring tissue of and neighboring tissue of nucellus. Meanwhile, the functional megaspores greatly enlarge in size. Its nucleus divides and the two daughter nuclei move to two opposite poles. Its nuclei divide to give rise two nuclei which move toward opposite poles. The nuclei divide twice, resulting in the formation of eight nuclei. Meiosis first and meiosis second take place in first division is mitotic. These two nuclei are 2N structures, then these both divide meiotically forming four nuclei at each end. The embryo size increases in size and then one nuclei from each end passes toward the center forming the polar nuclei. one neon nuclei from both sides. Polar nuclei afterwards fuse with each other to form two young secondary nuclei. These polar nuclei fuse to form secondary nuclei. The three nuclei of micropylar ends surrounded by a very thin wall and constitute the egg apparatus. Three nuclei of this size, one middle is egg nuclei and two synergies are SSA nuclei. They form the egg apparatus. Out of this middle larger nuclei is egg nuclei and two synergids, and three nuclei of Challenger ends form the antipodal cells or antipodal nuclei. Now the functional Vega spores, normally Challenger Vega spore is functional and forming female gametophyte, which develop into embryo sacs, and remaining three are degenerated.